presented by Ontario, Canada, in partnership with Destination Ontario, Strike King Lure Company, St. Croix Rods.
All right, heading back up to Northeastern Ontario for another lodge experience at Lake Herridge Lodge and Resort near the area of Temagami. And this area is renowned for walleye, smallmouth, northern, you name it, man. It's got whitefish. So many opportunities, but it's a new place with some owners that just took over a couple years ago. So it's got some history, the place. It's got great family amenities, but the fishing is just lights out. The guys are saying that the walleyes average 19 to 21. Now, at Lake Herridge Lodge, they have opportunities to fish for walleye and smallmouth on remote lakes that see very little pressure. And you know me, I'm a bass hound. So any chance to fish big smallmouth with not a lot of pressure, usually I'm in. But the chance to get those 20 plus inch walleyes on lakes that nobody touches, and you say to yourself, okay, I'm gonna weigh the pros and cons here. What's the weather like? Is it ideal walleye weather? Like overcast, little chop, maybe a little rain in the air? Nope. Exact opposite. Mother Nature says, we're gonna make it tough for you. Slick, 90 degrees, calm, bluebird skies, but right here, it doesn't matter because these walleyes have not been touched.
That one is a walleye. Pretty sure it's, oh, that's a good fish. Yeah, that feels not bad. Brett, it might be, he's near the surface.
Oh, yeah.
Those walleyes come up like that?
Sometimes, yeah. The mouth will be open.
Yeah. Where are you? Walleye? Walleye. Look at that.
Nice.
In the same spot.
Perfect.
Wow, eh? Nice.
That's a nice fish.
Yep. Wow, they do that nice color here, eh? Oh, boy. Nice. Beautiful colors. Look at those walleyes, man. Look at that. For good luck. That's being optimistic, folks. Here. Ready, walleye? Ready? He's like, wow. He let me go.
Yeah, right on.
On this trip, Brad said, you know, these walleyes move a lot on these back lakes. So we're going to use a little good old-fashioned blade and bead spinner rig, okay? With two little hooks, attach a good old-fashioned night crawler. He's got the ones called jigger knot tackle. And it's real simple. Big shiny blade that just spins. You attach a split shot about 20 inches above and attach it with a swivel so it doesn't twist up all your line. Cast out to the back of the boat and just slow power drift. And I know he knows what he's doing because a lot of times he's engaging, changing the speed, zigzagging the boat, and that makes a big difference than just putting the motor down, going in a straight line and hoping to get bit. A good guide, a good lodge owner knows that he wants to put his customers, and guys like myself, on fish fast. So moving back and forth, alternating the speeds, and getting to locations where those walleyes are.
Oh. Yeah.
Good one?
Yeah. That's a good one.
He stays down. Maybe yeah. It could be what we're thinking it is, right?
Here he comes.
Oh, nice walleye.
That's a nice one.
Beautiful walleye. Wow, look at the colors on that thing, dude. You're right. Gorgeous, Brad.
Gorgeous, eh?
Oh, yeah. Gorgeous fish.
Like, that's about the average in here. Yeah, he's in this line. He's about 17 and a half.
Yeah, that's a little releaser, huh?
Almost 18, yeah.
Yeah, beautiful.
Nice fish.
Oh yeah, let him go and swim, eh?
There we go.
Gorgeous walleye.
Go
on, fish.
Yeah,
lucky
little.
You.
So we were throwing that little steel worm harness, okay, with the blade and the beads, I call it, night crawlers, but we're just going slow enough. Another option, especially these fish, like I said, they haven't seen a lot of baits or a lot of anglers, so they're somewhat naive, but you still gotta find them. So Brad's got these little reefs that come up and they taper off down to like this real dark water. I would throw maybe like those little lucky shad by Strike King. Chartreuse, orange, bright colored bait. It looks like a little shad bait. Deep nose, goes down about 8 feet. Just slowly working it. Every time he stops, it'll start coming up. That'll trigger those walleyes.
There's a good fish right there, dude. Oh yeah, that's a good fish, dude. Oh yeah, that's a good fish. Oh yeah. I don't know if that's, whoa. Walleye or pike, but it's big.
Nice.
Oh yeah. Whoa. Might be a big Walter. I'm not gonna jinx it, but don't want to force it now. Here we come. I can see the split shot.
Oh,
that is
nice,
a big walleye.
Yeah.
Yes. And there you go.
Oh, shit. No, I'm not there yet. Oh, no.
Oh, no. What's...
He's in.
Okay. Oof. Nice, Walter.
Oh, he's a nice one.
Beautiful fish. You're right about big, beautiful walleyes here. But to respect this fishery, we gotta let these big, beautiful fish go. Look at that. Just beautiful, golden Ontario walleye. Wow. Ready? Ready, big girl? Man, she earned her keep. What a scrap, man. What a time. Lake Herridge up here, they've got all these remote lakes and a couple short portages and just back and forth. Look at the conditions. You say prime walleye? Well, actually it's not, and we're not even fishing deep, but good reproduction, good respect for the fishery, catch and release, keeping those 16 and unders and stuff. You're allowed to keep one over, but I'm not going to do that. You know, I just want to have fun with them. And just slow power trolling, real easy. Split shot, come down to a little swivel so you don't twist up all your line. And Brad's got these little worm harnesses, single blade with the beads, that's it. And live bait, can't beat walleye fishing. Of course, Icon.
Yeah, I am impressed. Really big, beautiful, black and yellow walleyes, you know, beautiful fish in Northern Ontario. And it's, again, they're relating to that rock and the dark color water. So again, make passes back and forth, go up, grow on the sides of it. And if you get too close, you get stuck on the bottom. Even with one split shot, if you get too close, you get stuck. We stay back on that tapered edge where it goes about 8 to 10 feet. And that's where those walleyes are staging.
Yeah. I just missed one too. Good bite?
Yeah, it feels nice.
Like an eater?
Yeah. Staying way down. Oh, maybe a bit bigger.
Oh, yeah. Nice walleye. Oh,
yeah,
boy.
He's in the slot, yeah.
What a spot, man. Now look at him fight.
Oh, yeah. No,
it's either me or you he doesn't like.
Yeah. Eh? Or that pike, too.
Right. Uh-oh. And you're in the net, dude.
Is.
Another beautiful walleyes. Wow, dude. You got a good fishery here, man.
Oh, yeah.
21 inch, man.
Yeah.
Let's show him a good shot. Look at that. Wow.
Nice pickerel, yeah. Slot size.
Nice one, man.
Oh, yeah. Get him back.
Let her go and let her spawn again, right?
Yeah.
Wow, what a fishery. What a fishery. Well, we're looking for eaters. Think about that. Looking for eaters.
Yeah.
We got a northern on a stringer, and we started off this morning getting some eaters. And I got kind of cocky. I was like, oh, we're going to get all kinds of eaters. Look how fast we caught this one. And then what happens? We're getting all big ones. But, man, what a place.
Yeah.
Lake Herridge. Think about it, man. You want to catch some fun walleyes? They got all kinds. What do you got, about five lakes like this?
Yeah.
And yeah, the main exactly. Lake too, right?
And then there's Herridge, yeah.
Yeah, and then the Herridge.
You know it's a good fishery when you can't catch those walleyes under 16 inch. Sure, he says there's days where a lot of guys catch those 14 to 16, 17 inch, but I think that the creel size or the slot limit here is just under 17 ship to throw those back. But he said a lot of days they catch those fish, but today it was about the big walleyes.
Big walleye come up and eat. Oh, I missed a bite right there. Not that time. That's a good one, dudes. That's a big one again. Oh boy. That's another big walleye, I'll bet you, dude. On this side, back here. He's already at the boat. Yeah, he's here. Oh yeah, look at that.
Nice one.
And, whoa.
Hold on, go away.
There you go. He might be under. Ooh. Oh boy. Now we can hold him safe, he doesn't flop around. Let's see what he looks like. Nice.
Beautiful. Fins up.
Yep. So from the top of the tail, oh boy, 19 plus.
Yeah, just over 19.
Yeah.
Sure.
Let's show him that again and then we'll let him go. Wow.
Yeah.
Good fishery, man.
Right on. Get him back.
Oh, yeah, for sure, man.
Nice
line,
please.
Yes. There he goes. Good kick. Wow, eh? Yeah. We just came off that area. You got that ridge, right?
Yeah.
And we just, when it went down, I just cast it behind the boat. And we're going down, I felt pop. I opened up some slack, let it go down about 5 feet, and then Wow, man. Brad, you got a real special fishery here. But again, catch and release. If the people keep fishing, they're going to catch those 16s, right?
That's just 15, it. 16? Yeah, you will get them. Yeah.
But you just got to put up with the big ones in between.
That's just it. Yeah. Yeah. You got to put up with the bigger fish.
Great fishery, dudes.
And now it's time for the Extreme Edge.
Fishing with the Fat Baby Finesse, rigged on heavy power rod, casting rod. You know, when I fish with this worm, split shot rigs for smallmouth and stuff, and I'm gonna fish a really popular lake, clear water. We'll just try to dissect trees, rocks, points, different things with that little fat worm in the brand new Moon Juice. This color is psychotic, really. Just came out last year at ICAST, but it's just another piece of the arsenal to help you catch fish. So I'll show you the tools of how I do it with the little finesse, using the power poles, keeping the trolling motor on low, and just dissecting areas like these trees, bushes, pads and stuff, and trying to find fish and then force them with the power of the heavy rod so I can make them fight, you know, not just spinning rod stuff. This is gonna be about powering, hitting them, pull them to the boat, kiss them and release them. The 7.4 Heavy Power Legend X by St. Croix. Low profile, casting reel, Tatula by Daiwa, nice and smooth. I can make long pitches. And this here is not about the finesse you think about. You know, you say, okay, you said finesse worm and stuff. That's it right there. Little fat baby finesse, but rigged on a 3-odd wide gap hook, on a 3/16 tungsten weight, slow fall. I'm gonna be fishing all shoreline stuff, you know, picking apart little things, depressions, trees, bushes, points of rock, different things like that, you know. So I want it to fall slow. It's a small worm, but I mean, it's just another option, and it's in the Moon Juice. Say Moon Juice. That new color last year, Steve Park showed me at ICAST, and I was like, dude, that is psychotic. You know, he's got it in different rage baits and different things, but this here, in that little fat baby finesse, the little kick and tail, I mean, when fish see this, they eat it, man. So I got it on this one, I put 16 pound gamma edge, okay? And the reason is the power finesse. When I hit fish with this, I want to make them fight. And guess what's there? Yeah, largemouth. Or is it small jaw? Oh, no, it's small jaw. Look at that. Small jaw on a worm, huh? Look at that. Fat baby finesse, huh? He ate it too. Look at him. He's a good one. Look at that. What do you think of that? What do you think of that little worm now, eh? Fat baby finesse gets me a fat baby bass. Look at him. Look at him, eh? Look where he's got that. I'd say, look at that. Look how lean and green. Beautiful, man. But they disappear in the water. Let's put her back right here, huh? Roaming on the rocks, huh? Come on. Okay, here's how I'm gonna rig that little fat baby finesse. Put it in through the nose, okay? Pinch it into about an inch. Turn it, punch it up through. Thread it up on the hook, over the line tie, okay? Then I bring it down about 3/4 of the way, and then just punch it through like that. Take that worm weight, put the bobber stop back down. There's your setup, but here's the key. See how the nose is sticking out like that? I don't want that like that because it's gonna grab things. So I get it and I just pinch that little nose like that. That's my setup right there. The fat baby finesse on the heavy power rod right there. Killer presentation. Carl's not gonna rush right here. Oh, big. Look at him. Okay. Big, beautiful, large mouth. Look at him. You saw my little fat baby finesse, huh? One more jump. Gonna turn you. Where are you? Hey, where are you? Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Open your mouth. Oh, gotcha. Look at him. Wow, eh? I got another tag on him. Look on top of his fin. Another tag. And look where that worm is. Right there. Wow, huh? Fish in the rocks, hey, wood, you name it. Pop it out. Oh, you talk about those sharp hooks. Look at that. Isn't that a gorgeous bass? Look at him. Beautiful, heavy largemouth. Beautiful fish. I'll tell you what, I let him go right here, okay? Right here, right now. Look at him. Huh? Ready? Go on. Gone. That's how you do it with the little worm. Use everything in your boat, trolling motor, garments to find the stuff on the sides, the power poles to put down. But I can't tell you how important it is to fish slow. When you're doing that kind of stuff, even with a little finesse worm like that, you want to put it in those spots. Give the fish a chance to put their mouth on it, turn, and move. They're not going to spit these baits. They're so soft, they're so real, they taste great. You put everything in your advantage, you will catch them.
Here at Lake Herridge Lodge, we have 10 cabins. We can accommodate about 40 to 45 people. We have a beautiful beach, great for families, lots of area to swim and play around. We have a bunch of beach toys as well. So like I said, it's very family friendly. Beautiful main lodge as well with a pool table, satellite TV, just to escape those rainy days, right? At Lake Herridge Lodge, we also offer remote lake fishing packages. And we take you through a series of remote lakes, including four series of lakes, Herridge onto three other lakes. And the fishing throughout the entire lake system is just fantastic. Our cabins range from bachelor style to a 9-person cabin, and they range from about four to six people each. They're fully equipped with fridge, stove, microwave, coffee machine, toaster, everything you'd need to get away. And we pride ourselves in cleanliness. That is definitely top priority to us. At Lake Herridge Lodge, we promote catch and release, but if you did want to have a little shore lunch, it's no problem to keep small walleye under the slot, or bass and pike as well. They're great fish to eat, and it's such a healthy system around here. And we also have a boat launch as well, so people can bring their own boats. We have a great docking system, as you can see behind us. Recently, a guest caught a 31-inch walleye. Beautiful, beautiful fish. And it was just great. He was very happy about it, and it made his trip. We welcome all our guests from Canada and the United States. We have a great place. You will definitely enjoy your time here, and we welcome you with open arms. Come visit us at Lake Herridge Lodge and Resort in Temagami, Ontario.
All right, we go to this reef that he's got that runs right across the lake from point to point. And the point that we're on, big boulders going out about 200 yards. It just tapers slow, like you talk about a walleye and smallmouth magnet. But the edges just taper down.
The old school, doing the drift, bouncing the bottom. You got him?
Yeah.
That passed. How's he feel?
He feels like a pickerel.
Let me know. I'll get this out of the way.
Yeah, here he comes.
Good walleye?
Yeah, it's
a big one. Oh, nice, nice, nice. Let's see where we are. Oh, boy, hey. Whoop. Oh. You see all the net again? Let's see, there you go.
There you go.
Just like you said, old school drift, eh?
Yeah.
On the edge of the reef. That's a nice chunk. He's in the slot for sure.
Nice pickerel, yeah.
Yeah, he's probably 18. Nice, healthy walleye.
Oh yeah, it's a bit of blue on him.
I see that too.
Yeah, and on the tail.
Very nice.
Yeah.
See ya, buddy. Close. Didn't know it hit him.
Yeah.
Well, let's finish this trip. Maybe finish for the day. What do you think?
Yeah, I'm up for
it. Okay.
The day's almost done. Let's get up the top end of that and do one or two more drifts. What happens? Brad gets a good 17. While I put my rod down, I see it go boom, and then wah, my rod is ready to go over the side of the boat. I lift up, set hook, and I'm like, dudes, this is a big fish.
Oh, you got one?
Yeah, I got a good one too.
Oh, here.
Oh yeah, that's a big one, dude.
Oh, nice.
Let's see.
That's a big one here.
Oh yeah, that's a big one. Oh boy. That's a good one.
Might have to net them both at the same time.
Uh-oh. Look at him coming down, playing possum. Uh-oh. Might need the net.
A nice fish. I got to leave him in the net. He's all hooked
okay.
up.
Oh boy.
Oh, he's big.
Yeah.
He's a nice fish, man.
Yeah. Ready? There you go.
Nice.
There's an ending to your show. Hey, dude. Hey, Lake Herridge. See Lake the phone number on the screen right now? You best call it, boys and girls, because the walleyes are big and there's plentiful. Come here, big girl. You made my day at Herridge Lodge. Oh, see ya.
There he goes.
You want big walleyes? Think about this place right here. You know, Brad and his wife really have everything you want. Fantastic accommodations, great location, beach, clean places. But what's really important to you? Really? Catching big, beautiful walleyes, man. But we got to do what we did here today. Catch them, release them. We got some smaller ones to eat, have the pike and stuff. But just, man, respect this kind of fisher, because this will be here for years if you do that. You come here, you can have fun like I had. And it's just, it's someplace you got to consider. Call the number on the screen, look at the email, let them know that you want to come over here to Tomogamy and catch some beautiful walleyes. We appreciate you watching. We'll see you next time on The Extreme Angler. Maybe right back with this guy right here. Thanks for watching. We'll see you.
Extreme Angler has been presented by Ontario, Canada, in partnership with Destination Ontario, St. Croix Rods, Strike King Lure Company, Rage Tail Soft Baits, Gamma Fishing Lines, Power Pole. Visit us at fishextreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.